creativity was something that I always thought was interesting as just an area within the arts and so forth. But what really motivated me to start to study it is that every time I worked in organizations, I'd consistently come up with ideas, and my managers would say, "That's a great idea, very creative, but..." And constantly with, you know, we have rules, or at one workplace, they went all the way up to the third level of command to get approval, and it got squashed, the idea I had. And so, essentially, I felt like organizations were not open to creativity. As a field, creativity is not as well developed as some other fields. It's become much more of a strong research interest for people, but it's a newer field, and so there's quite a few topics that you could study. I think there's issues having to do internationally with our different contextual factors or personal factors important in certain cultures. We really don't know as much about across cultures. There's issues having to do with what we call the dark side of creativity. So, you know, creativity doesn't always mean it's positive. It could have negative repercussions. There could be ethical issues having to do with it. There's still a host of contextual factors and different environmental factors that you could still study. So it's fairly wide open. And then I guess the last thing I'd mention is team creativity. That's something that's newer. More people have studied it on the individual level. There's a very good, strong relationship between creativity and HRM. If you think about any of the human resource practices that exist in organizations, they can be related to creativity. You know, or employees' creative performance. So, you know, selection systems, training systems, performance appraisal, the types of rewards and recognition people are given, the entire organizational climate. So I think that there's a very, very close connection between HRM and creativity. I think that everybody can be creative. I think that people can be creative in all different arenas. Some people are creative in many different arenas. Some are creative in only a few. But I think everybody has the potential to be creative at some time under certain conditions. There's a few things they can do. One of the most important things, I think, is to actually ask for creativity, to tell employees that you want creativity, and also to signal that creativity will be rewarded and recognized. And so I think you can go quite a ways at work by saying we value creativity. We desire it. We'd like our employees to try to be creative. And on the flip side, if they try to be creative and it doesn't work, not to punish them. So there's always that downside of you know, someone who tries to be creative, they really work hard at it, it doesn't work, and it's seen as a failure, and they're punished for it, or there's negative repercussions for it. The most important things that managers should remember about employee creativity, there's a few things to consider. The first is that anybody can be creative, and it's possible in any type of job. Obviously, in some jobs, you'd rather have higher levels of creativity than in other jobs. So there's that it's possible in any job. It's possible of any person. And so I think managers have to think about how can we, if we want a certain level of creativity, how can we manage the work context to be able to facilitate that level of creativity? And there's a lot of research now on the work context, and how you can set up the work context to be more supportive of creativity or not to be harmful for creativity. There's quite a bit of research on encouraging individuals to be creative. There's less research on encouraging teams to be creative, but there's some similarities and differences between the two literatures. The first is that most of the personal and contextual factors that we found affect creativity are true for both individuals and teams. Now, where we have the differences are compositionally and process-wise. So when we talk about teams, we have to talk about the team composition. You know, how many people are in the team, what types of people are in the team, what's the impact of having different people from different, for example, functional backgrounds be in the team. So that's the compositional issue that also relates to the process issue. If we have a diverse team, is that good or bad for creativity? It depends, and a lot of it depends on the process. Can they interact together? Are they productive in terms of their meetings? Do they pay attention to each other? Do they work well together? And so there's the process issues that you have to think about that you don't think about as much when you're dealing with individuals because they're working on a problem themselves. I think the biggest mistake that organizations make when it comes to creativity is that they assume that only certain types of people can be creative, or they assume that only types of jobs require creativity. And so they tend to, if you want to say, marginalize creativity or put it in certain types of jobs, for example, research and development, which creativity is important for that type of job, but is also important for your administrative staff to be creative or for your knowledge workers to be creative. And so there's a certain amount of creativity that's possible in any type of job, and I think a lot of times organizations don't consider that. Potentially, there are downsides to encouraging creativity at work. I think anytime you have the possibility of good things happening from a work practice, you also have the potential downside. And so when I was talking about creativity being good in any type of job, you think of something like research and development, where you'd say, of course they have to be creative. An example that comes up a lot when I talk to different management groups is, do you want your accountant to be creative? Now, you personally might say, I'd love my accountant to be creative, somewhat creative, so that I can get more back on my tax returns or something like that. But someone else might say, no, I don't want them to be creative at all, and that could actually cause a problem. The biggest takeaway from my research that I'd like people to remember is that creativity can be managed. And the best way to manage creativity is to manage the work context, to pay attention to what factors research has shown help to promote creativity at work and what factors are actually harmful for employees' creativity. I think managers can understand about that, manage the work context, and they're more likely to have creativity occur across their workforce.